every fast when she crunches the skin. The sweated palms and picked up with her hand. With a giggle and a tip of her hair, the smell of pheromones in the air. Snicking cuckoo eyes over the food, then they might help you to set the mood. She's got to know what you're feeling.
Where are you going?
To get more firewood before your fire dies.
Thank you. expression full of such a hideous, ugly beast.
But I thought that wouldn't matter to you.
Yeah, well, it does. Right on time. I bought you a little something.
Whoa, broomstick horse. Princess Fiona?
As promised, now about my swamp.
Cleared up as a breeze, and the deed has been put in your name. Now step away before I change my mind. Forgive me, Princess Fiona, for startling you. Why, I'm Lord Farquaad.
Lord Farquaad, forgive me for I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, that's so sweet, but you don't have to waste good manners on that ogre. It's not like he has feelings.
No, you're right, it doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona, I ask your hand in marriage. Will you be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing would make me.
Excellent. I'll start the plans for tomorrow. We wed.
No! Let's get married today before sunset.
Oh, anxious are we? You're right, the sooner the better. Guard, tell him it's a code red. We'll be married by sunset.
Oh, man, there's nothing like a good night's sleep. Woo! What I miss?
Fairly well, Ogre.
Shrek! You let her get away. You don't know about this, but I talked to her last night, and...
Yeah, I know you talked to her last night. You two are great pals, aren't you? So why don't you go home with her?
But Shrek, I want to go home with you.
Me? No. I live alone. Nobody else. Especially without pathetic, useless, talking donkeys.
But I thought...
Yeah, well, you thought wrong.
You think life can't get any worse?
I thought you were
going to
help us.
He said he had kicked us out.
But what do you expect from an ogre?
We believed in you.
Grow up.
I won't grow up.
Then get out of my way.
Well, there he goes again, pushing everyone away, just like he did to me, just like he did to Fiona. You're so wrapped up in layers, onion boy, you're afraid of your feelings.
Who's Fiona?
She's a princess who loves him.
Oh, there's a girl?
The princess loves him.
Loves me? She set up an ugly, hideous beast.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about, somebody else.
Really? Then who was she talking about?
Oh, now he's interested. 2 minutes ago, he was all, don't talk to me. Go away. I don't need nobody.
Okay, look, I'm sorry. I'm honestly sorry. I guess I'm just a big, stupid ogre, which is why me and the princess can never be together.
Listen up, ogre.
We spend our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
The way they think, that is.
That's right.
Let your feet, 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 let your fe
take Princess Fiona.
I do.
And do you, Princess Fiona?
I do. Stop the wedding!
Shrek? Fiona, I have something that I need to tell you.
Oh, now you want to talk? Well, it's a little late for that, so you'll excuse me.
You can't marry him.
And why not?
Because he's just marrying so he can be king.
Oh, that is so not true. Princess Fiona, don't listen to him.
He's not your true love.
Guards, who let this thing in here?
Let's hear what the monster has to say. It might be worth a laugh.
Oh, you are awful. Go ahead, Ogre. You heard her. Express yourself with as few words as possible.
Okay, It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities all around. True love is blind, maybe you won't find love. You've never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities ahead.
Thank you. today I'm at the presentation of Shrek Jr. at Willard Intermediate School, and it was fantastic. The kids did a phenomenal job, and the teachers as well. I mean, I just cried, I laughed so hard, and got an opportunity to just really see raw talent and passion, because the kids had a blast, and you could tell the whole time that they were having a good time. So this is what it's all about, is arts education in our schools, and we want to make sure that we encourage our kids and give them every opportunity to exceed and compete. So thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Amy Beltran. I'm the music teacher here at Willard Intermediate School, and we just performed Shrek Jr. with our kids here from grade 6th grade through 8th grade. They worked on sets, they worked on costumes, learned music, and they had a blast doing it. We hope you enjoy it. So we're here with the leads from the musical Shrek Jr. And let's start with Lord Farquaad. What's your name?
Kevin Duran.
And what grade are you in?
6.
And is this the first time you've ever been in a show?
It's my first time in a musical, but I've been in concerts.
Nice. And you?
Victor Flores.
What grade are you in?
7th.
And is this your first time in a musical?
Yes.
What did you think about the whole experience?
Pretty fun.
Pretty fun. Would you do it again?
Yeah.
How about you?
Carlos Flores. I'm in 7th grade, and this is my second time doing a musical. And I actually thought it was pretty fun. Again, I would do it next year, too.
Great.
My name is Michelle Kirk, and I'm in 8th grade, and this is my first time doing a musical.
What did you think of the experience?
It was a challenge, but it was really fun.
Great. So the whole process took about 10 weeks, and we taught the kids some choreography, some music. We worked on costumes, sets, and all the acting.